G'day, welcome to the MacPack. My name's Jay McKenna, and to my left, this week in order, the man on the panel who's most likely to get a driving fine. It's my little brother Joe. How are you, boy?
Yes, it seems to be the case because I have been fined. Oh, we'll get into that soon.
To my right, coming in at 6-1 as he does each and every week. It's the baby brother of the pack who we call Junior Boy. How are you, mate?
Strategically driving too fast so the cameras can't catch me.
There we go. Oh, you're a bit of a zoomie.
That's it, a zoomie. Zoomies. I'm a zoomer.
Nice. We're chatting about Joe's latest New Zealand trip off the top. I know we've done it a few times now, but some new news has come to the pod. So we're going to be undressing that. We've also got Whistle Game, which we haven't played since like fucking September or something of last year. So I got to remember how to do that. Plus, we've got a Harry Styles story.
He's back in the news.
And Riley's got a hero. Plus, we've got one big out this week. It's a massive bet. Let's get into it. Boys. How are we all?
Yes, I'm feeling fantastic.
Big week. Massive ups to Tim Blackwell for joining us last week on the podcast. Plenty of lovely feedback. If you haven't yet gone, and I'd suggest watching it. Don't listen to it. I'd suggest watching it because it's actually really good to watch him in the studio.
Yeah, it's cool.
But yeah, massive shout out to him. Thank you so much for joining us, Timbo. Never thought I'd call him Timbo.
Jake Bo.
We had another guest lined up for today.
We did, yes. With it being Mother's Day on Sunday. As we do each and every year, we do a Mother's Day episode on the Friday before Mother's Day. Everything was going to plan until about 24 hours ago, and then the talent had contract negotiations with the pack, and we just couldn't come to an agreement. Unfortunately, Mum's gotten quite crook over the last 24 hours, so she's actually pretty much bedridden.
Mumbo.
So we will not be deleting the idea of having Mum on the pod. We're just going to delay it 1 week. So it'll be a post... It'll be a post Mother's Day episode, but it'll still be very much centered around Mothers and Mother's Day. And if you have any questions, queries, anything you want to ask Mum, make sure to slide into her DMs before then. And make sure, let's give her a fair bit. She's going to be coming back off the bug.
Yep.
Give her plenty of love before she joins us next Friday as well, just to make it, because she's feeling pretty...
If she was all right, she'd be here.
Yeah, she was very disappointed that she couldn't make it. I actually just arrived and... Mainly just to go check on how she was going. And I was like, we'll do it next week. She goes, no, I'll be right. And it just like, I'd rather you not like vomit on the panel.
She was going to have a Jordan flu game on air.
Yeah.
Just zingers left and right.
So next week she'll be back in vogue. She'll be feeling fresh and we'll have her on then.
Fantastic. She could review our gifts or something.
Yeah.
If we get her anything.
We planned.
We're going to kick things off this week with a bit of a chat. Joey, something has come across our desk. Well, you went to New Zealand about a month ago.
Yep.
And it seems to be the trip that just keeps on giving.
Yep.
It gave you syphilis because you kept rooting the sheep. It's given us a fair few stories to do.
No, that's not true.
It's given us a few stories to talk about since. You've been basically sick. Mum's probably got your little sheep flu that you seem to have for the entire time that you were in New Zealand and then the entire time you've been back since. But this week, it gave us some financial and criminal news.
Yeah, I gotta say, it's hard being the bad boy on the panel.
It's so hard, in fact, you can't even say it, bro.
The bad boy on the panel.
Yeah.
It's very hard, but I have run into a bit of a criminal charge in New Zealand, that's right.
Classic Joey.
It's traffic related, one of the most bad boy-esque things you can get, that's right. And infringing on traffic.
You talked about it last time we were talking about New Zealand. You mentioned the fact that all their speed limits are like 30, 40, 50 kilometers an hour.
Yeah, wimp stuff. Little wimpy speed limits. But that wasn't what got me. Well, actually, I did later on get a speeding fine, but that's not what I wanted to do.
Hang on. You get two. You got multiple fines.
Two, yeah.
Are you allowed to be back in the country?
They ain't catching me.
That's not what that means.
They ain't catching me, my man.
Well, you got two speeding fines while speeding in New Zealand.
Hey. In a lone car.
Hey. Not two speeding fines. One.
Okay.
In a separate... traffic infringement.
Oh, that's from the speeding fine, though.
It was only I was doing 60 in a 50 or whatever.
And like the gun went off?
I didn't see no gun.
Well, what, like, how did it get you? Or was it a police?
Yeah, it must have been, yeah.
Oh, right. Okay, so the flash went off.
Not that I saw. I thought I was home free. Yeah. But it was like, you know, when you're going down, you're going like 100 on the freeway, and then it's like, all right, now we're in a town, so it's 50. So it's probably slowing down or something, you know.
Oh, so that's what happened. You went from 100 to...
Yeah, because I was on state highway.
You're saying that like we've been slash no. What the fuck are you talking about?
Yeah, you know, sometimes if you're driving down to the country, you'll be on like a freeway, highway.
And then there's a satellite.
And then it's just a town.
Yeah.
Right.
Yeah. So that's where they got me. But the speeding ticket, only $30.
That's cheap.
I would have been gunning it the whole trip if I knew it was that little.
What does that equate to over here? Group here.
Like 29. It's basically the same.
A bit of a discount.
Nice.
But that wasn't the one that caused me grief.
Right.
The one that caused me grief was the aforementioned traffic infringement when I was driving in a bus zone.
In a bus zone?
Exactly.
You're making it sound like only buses can go in this area.
That's exactly...
Were you at the bus station?
No, not the bus station. Right, so this is who I am. I'm driving in Auckland, the main city, the big smoke.
Yeah.
And I'm driving around.
The big apple, don't they call it?
It's hard because there's so much roadworks going on. So your map is saying turn here, but you can't because all these roadworks going on. They're working on the roads over there. In 20 years, they're going to have a great road. So I get to one point and I'm driving around trying to kind of get like to the IMAX or whatever to watch.
Oh.
So I was, you know, I was like, wanted to get there. And then I'm driving around trying to find this place.
Yeah.
And then I'm just driving straight. And then I see this like big writing on the road. It's like buses only kind of thing.
And you said, that's me.
What do you mean kind of thing? It's that tapped on at the end.
It's like buses only on the road.
Kind of thing.
Like, it's like...
They're very casual.
It's like before a traffic light, a few like lane, like you probably fit a couple cars and, or maybe one or two cars and it's painted.
Yeah.
So I thought maybe like...
We have the same stuff here though. We have painted bus lanes.
Yeah, but this wasn't on the lane. This was across multiple lanes before the lights.
Oh.
So I was like...
Like a pedestrian crossing.
It looked like a pedestrian crossing, but for a bus. And I was like...
Why are they going in the wrong way?
Well, I was like... that's the thing. I didn't know. There was buses over this side in the left-hand lane stopping and picking people up. So I was like, I guess that's a bus lane. I don't know what this thing on the ground is for.
Bus
lane. So I just kept driving. And then... Thought nothing of it. And then I come back, they sent me three very, very high definition photos of me driving in this.
Oh, can we see them? Why have you not bought them? Oh, he's bought them.
Oh, I got the email.
How can they get you? You're in a different country.
Yeah, but my name is on the rental car.
Do they just think you're like...
Yeah, what's the rental business called? Have you been banned from them?
No, they're happy with that.
They're happy about
they're stoked.
They charge a fee to get to send me the ticket.
Oh.
Which is a bit steep in my mind.
So how much do they charge a year?
$50.
They're charging
just
50
to send you an email.
And the ticket's only 30.
Yeah, no, this ticket's 150.
What?
So this is me, right?
Surely you're...
This is me driving next to the bus lane.
Why you you're in a different car.
You're naked.
Nah, ignore those ones.
Why is there a sheep in the background?
Okay, so that's Joe's little...
So wait, I'm driving next...
Stop bus. That's what it says on the road.
Yeah, and I'm not driving in the bus lane, right? Yeah. And then see, that's the green bit I was telling about.
Oh.
Okay.
See that, right?
Yeah.
And then another one. See, they have so many photos, right?
In my opinion, where you've done the wrong thing yet. You're just
what I thought.
Driving on the road.
What is driving?
It is in a white lane behind a bus.
Surely you're fighting this and just plead Australian.
I looked it up, right? Because I looked at the thing. I was like, oh, I've driven the bus lane. I was like, oh, fair enough. And I looked at
the time you were aware. At the time you were like, well, that was a bit weird.
I thought it was weird. I was like, I don't know what that sign was for. I don't know why the painting
and why the
for.
Paparazzi have come out for the big Joey.
And then so I looked it up, right? Because I was like, this is kind of weird. I looked at the photo and I was like, I don't really get what I did wrong.
I still can't.
These are quite high def. They're very high def. Color.
Yeah, they're in color, yeah.
Which is quite a nice
So I looked it up. In Auckland, there's 150 meters of road, basically between one set of traffic lights and another set of traffic lights.
Yeah.
Where only buses are allowed.
And what happens to the cars?
You get a $150 fine.
If you're in there.
Yeah.
That seems like a trap.
They made the change, right?
A day before you got
a couple years ago, they made the change. In the first 16 months since they made the change, they made $5.6 million in fines.
Oh, wow.
Because it's not clear what the hell is going on.
So the moment that you said, is it an alternative route?
I guess you're meant to turn.
Into a bus.
No, like at the lights. It doesn't make sense. I fought it. I said that... I was like, look, we have bus lanes. We don't have
stop
streets
bus.
That you can't.
We don't have
stop bus. Don't have a stop bus. Sorry.
Yeah, stop bus.
And, also, I'm not a bus. I'm not stopping. I'm going on.
What it says is like goods and it's like GV vehicles and bus. I don't know what a GV vehicle
goods
is,
and
but
services.
I thought it could have been.
Goods
yeah, something like that. Like, it's just
GV.
No, that's weird. That's bizarre.
So I am fighting it.
Oh, we're intrigued.
Here we go.
He's. I think you're batting at 100% average. You took down a music festival a few years ago.
Yeah, took down Splendor.
Yeah, and now he's going to take on the whole of New Zealand's police force.
So I can do it. But I'll pay the speeding fine.
Obviously, because it's petty cash.
It's only 30.
Yeah, right.
And but I will be starting a GoFundMe for that.
Do they then hit you, do the crew hit you with a $50 amount?
Email
to send
fee.
You the...
Yep.
The speeding fine.
To send you an
to
email.
To send the speeding fine, yeah.
So they're making more money out of sending an email.
Yeah, they're doing all right.
Wow. Surely they could have batched them up together.
That's what I thought. But I guess they did come in like a week apart. But still. Chill out, guys.
That seems high.
Criminal.
It is high, yeah. That's gorentals.newzealand. Don't use them. Oh, actually, they were fine aside from the fine thing. And also when I smashed the windshield. But something like
Alrighty, boys. Been a hot minute since we played this one. I think we've only played it once before. We did a Coldplay version of it, and it went as
big tour.
Arguably as disastrous as possible. I think after the fact, you were all pretty much like, yeah, it sounded right.
A lot of the listeners thought that me and Riley were just bad at guessing them.
Yeah, like, we were struggling.
They thought they knew when they heard it.
Well, that fills me with a lot more confidence as we're about to step into the second ever edition.
Yes.
I think it would have been maybe October, maybe November.
It would have been before, like around the big concert.
Yeah. This week, we don't really have a theme.
Ooh.
It's mainly just like hits. It's just old school tunes. We've done a lot of stuff on Radio Fremantle recently, but we just sort of get to play the absolute tunes.
Just bangers.
Of yesteryear. And that is basically what this theme, I guess, is going to be. We're going to come up. It's whistle while we work it out. It's a pretty simple game. All it involves is me finding music that I quite like. I whistle the song, and then it's up to you two boys to guess exactly what the tune is. You can play along at home. It should be pretty remarkable whether it's good, bad, or indifferent.
Cause it's easy when he tells you the song. You don't know now the game hasn't begun. You can feel it coming through his throat.
I'll whistle
while we work it out.
I'll whistle
while we work it out.
It's an interesting game, and it's an interesting little intro. It's only the second time we've ever heard it.
We were all guessing when we were ready to go.
I was waiting for a second verse.
When's the next? There's no one whistled at all during it. There was just a lot of shouting. The game is pretty easy, as I made mention to. I'm whistling a song. You got to hear what the song is. This time, we're actually going to play the little clips of the songs after the fact. And for the most part, I'm going to try my best to actually just whistle them from the start. So they're not going to be the choruses.
Ooh.
They're going to be the start. Very exciting news. I don't know any of the songs that I'm about to do. I'm going to go through and pick them as we do them, which is probably the worst way you could ever do it. But nonetheless, we're going to kick things off. Do you want me to give you a tip? Do you want me to give you a hint? At least last time we had a little bit of a...
Maybe do it once and then we can guess and then hit us with a hint.
Yep. Best out of three, right?
Yep.
Okay. Shit the bed. And it's at this point in time I start to like think about the music right before I do it. All right.
Hey, Binger.
Yeah, good, man.
You excited
for the big game?
Okay, we're good. We're good. Ready? I think this is just going to come straight in with the chorus, so apologies for all that preamble. It is very much a game of I look at, or currently I'm looking at the names of the songs, and then I'm going, yeah, I can probably get that bit. All right, we're good?
Believe in you.
Okay, here we go. First one.
Ooh, this is good.
Riley.
Riley.
Hey, baby, DJ Otzi.
Spot on.
Yeah, that was good. It's like, you know, I like knew it. I could have sung along. But, you know, it was like, I'm trying to think, like, what
it was
that
when
song
you got
called?
To the, yeah. I want to make you mine, oh mine, but
yeah, good
that's
man,
when you got
it. Appreciate it. This was basically what we're going for here.
We love a bit of DJ Otzi.
That was good. That's good. Okay. Cool. Next one. So 1 point to Riley Boy. Congratulations, junior fella. Next up, as it comes literally up on a playlist, as I read, I'm skipping through about 200 different songs. We're going to go.
Riley, so it's at this point, I should remind you that if Riley gets the next one.
It's a quick game. It becomes a very quick game. All right.
He wins.
Next one. This one is a bit of a ripper. You should both understand what we're going for with this one. We are going to go from the very beginning because it is one of my favorite starts to a song of all time. Here we go. Was it good though for Quickie Just Cookie?
That was good.
Just boost a bit of confidence because it's not an easy task. Okay.
Riley. Damn it. You got in first, Joe.
It's quicker becoming a great segment. Isn't
I didn't know what the buzzer we were running with. It's Drops of Jupiter by Train.
Nice.
You got that as well?
I knew it was Drops of Jupiter. I didn't know who sings it.
I don't think that.
But
I
know
it didn't even get any. I think this is more just the intro. I don't even think we really even touched on any lyrics.
No, I think you did. Yeah.
Okay, there you go. For those playing along at home, hopefully you got that one as well. It's been a good little session from the Mac, I must admit. We might be going more.
Do best of five.
Best of five. Okay.
Joey's nice. Got a taste right, for it. Cool. And he wants more.
Good stuff, John. Next one. Fuck, it's actually really.
So buzz in with your name, Joe.
Yeah.
You little rat. I could have taken that from you.
No. Okay, ready? Here we go. Another one.
I looked over to see what song it was.
Okay, this is tough. Ready?
Yep.
But you guys have been good. And the whistling, I must admit, it's probably an 11 out of 10. Okay.
Joe. Oh. 1 week, Bare Naked Ladies.
He's got it.
I don't even know this song at all.
Bullshit.
You'll know it. I referenced it at dinner. Or earlier in the episode.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, no, when we were setting up for the episode.
Yeah?
Nah.
Can you hear it now?
I've heard the song before, but I was never going
to
hear it.
Chickity China to Chinese Chicken.
Are you allowed
to your brain
pardon?
Sits and your heart starts ticking. It's part of the song.
I reckon keep your political views to yourself.
B&L.
Whatever you want to do with your chicken.
It is Joe to two, Riley to one. Okay. If Joe gets the next one, he wins.
This one's good. This one's good. Everyone will like this one. Okay, here we go. It's tough. You've got to play it a little bit in your head so you get a rhythm. All right? So there's always going to be a small micro pause. Just talk to each other really quick.
A micro what? So me and Joe are going to be on Radio Freo this weekend, but it's only going to be me and Joe.
And we're good. Ready?
We're going to kill Jake.
Kill Jake.
Ready?
Riley. Bad day.
No.
Oh, no.
I can keep going.
No, you're going to let Joe have his guess.
Do I have to guess?
No, he does, not currently. I can keep going.
Oh, okay. So I can buzz back in, or does Joe?
Well, Joe gets a free hit.
I know who
gives Joe.
Don't whistle anymore, then.
Well, no, we'll give Joe 5 seconds of free. It's not fair on him. You just jump in on the first bait and go. Oh, now you got to guess.
I know who it's by.
Oh, you little esh.
Okay, you want to give us that?
Just haven't met you yet by Michael Bublé.
Oh, how fun! Joe wins by cheating. Yet again.
Yeah, that was well done, Joe.
This is my favorite song.
Well, clearly not.
I prefer Bublé's version than Jake's mouth.
There you go. This isn't necessarily the bit that I did. I always do the lyric bit.
These are way better than the Coldplay ones. You've been practicing.
Okay, good. We'll go one more just for fun because I'm having a good time.
Just to rub it in.
And everyone's. How many you got? One.
Joe's on three. Riley's on one. It's best out of five.
Oh, okay. You got off
this one's worth triple points.
You got off for the hot start as well.
This one is worth triple points.
I got one and then I let Joe have the other one so we'd go to best of three.
Yeah, the umpire's coming in. This one is worth triple points.
Oh, my God. That's exciting. Thanks, ump.
That's massive. That's massive for the game and the environment that surrounds it.
It's good for the league.
Yeah, it's good for the brand. It's good for the brand of the game.
Whistle FC.
Yeah. The extra points at the end.
Okay, we're good. Ready?
That means anyone can win.
Here we go, last one.
Even Jake could win.
Yeah, he's buzzing in.
I think the listeners are the real winners this one.
Riley.
Oh, that's a great whistle, by the way.
What was that? I have no...
Take a look at each other.
That's good. Doesn't even need
down the barrel of the gun.
Here we go.
You're the voice.
Oh, he got it.
Try and understand it, baby. Triple points. And Riley takes the win with merely seconds to remain.
Well done, Ross.
That was good. I had no idea from that first.
Okay, we'll do it together. Ready? All three of us have to whistle. Okay. Let's have a going out to the break, boys.
Nice ear rape.
What'd you call me?
It's three of us whistling into my
here we go. This is it.
This is peak podcasting.
It's a long intro. We don't do the intros. We just do the lyric bits. Here we go.
Oh, we can't skip. The chance to...
You whistled that bit.
Yeah.
Wow.
That's all I needed.
You got it.
It was triple points.
You got it.
It had to be a hard one.
Yeah, you go.
Then he got it, and then we didn't even do
get ready, Joe. This is it. It's your part. Joey can't whistle. Revealed here on the show.
Here we go.
Yeah.
Go sing past the whistle. Here we go. That's fucking beautiful.
Oh, shit.
Alrighty, boys. We love to delve with a little bit of news, a bit of saucy news, a bit of hot topics, a bit of hot goss, a bit of celebrity stuff. Junior boy, take it away.
We've got some big news today,
big, big
boys.
News. big news. It's not just big news. It's big news.
It's come across my desk, and it's from none other than a reliable source. The Guardian.
Guardian of the galaxy.
Is the Guardian a reliable source, Joe?
The Guardian... Drum roll, please. Is a very reliable, independent media source. That's right. It's getting an A+ from me.
There you go.
That's good to hear because the headline is Harry Stalker. Fuck. Harry Styles Stalker.
It's a weird one.
They swore in the headline.
Wow. It's really attention grabbing. They're really mixing things up down at the Guardian.
The headline is Harry Styles Stalker jailed for sending him 8,000 cards in 1 month.
Wow, the postage would have been so expensive.
A woman who stalked Harry Styles has been jailed and banned from seeing him before. You would assume that the jailing would be enough to ban him from seeing him.
No, because he does a few... He's like Johnny Cash. He does a few jail.
She was sentenced to 14 weeks imprisonment after pleading guilty on Tuesday to a charge of stalking involving serious alarm or distress.
Okay, let's stress it down. First thing, 8,000 cards...
In
correct?
Less than a month.
Let's say it's 30 day. 8,000 cards.
Cards.
We did this like for the Woolies guy, and we've received a lot of complaints about the, about how you know.
So is that business days? Well, they didn't seem to like when we did business days. So do all of them.
Do every fucking.
And they never sleep either. They work 24/7.
Yeah, CEOs not allowed to sleep.
CEOs work so hard. This stalker could be a CEO. They're on the grind set.
We're going 8,000 cards across 30 days. A simple division of, wowee, 267 cards every day.
And the thing that's really hard about that is imagine how many times you'd have to go to the toilet to get the feces to smear over them.
What?
It's just like a thing a stalker would do, you know?
Speaking from experience.
Send some weird stuff.
Speaking from
so cards.
Joe just puts shit on everything after last week. He's got so much of the stuff in a bucket in his room.
Actually, speaking of that,
back to the well of shit.
You had brunch.
I had brunch with one of my friends who I used to work at my old job.
You made it sound like you're working.
Oh, yeah. One of my friends from my old job.
Okay.
And I was talking about, oh, what have you been up to? And I was like, oh, we're doing we're doing the radio and stuff. And then she was like, oh, yeah, like, that's so cool and stuff. I've actually never listened to the podcast, right? And then I was like, oh, yeah, that's fine. And then I was like, oh, yeah, how have you been? And I was like, oh, I was actually sick, but like, I had a bit of a sinus infection or whatever. Just sort of skim past the gruesome details of the sickness.
Were you eating lunch? Or did you
we're having brunch, yeah.
Okay, yeah, you don't want to bring up
turd
story brunch.
And then anyway, last night I get a screenshot of the Joey Shady's Pants episode. And it says, man, you really underplayed your sickness.
From the same boss.
Not my boss. Oh.
Yeah, no, just someone I used to
work. No one's Joe's boss.
Oh, your
boss. So, the headline, though.
You're the boss.
The headline, though, we got a listener.
We'll take him anywhere we can get him. We appreciate that. Does she have an... we won't go in the name. Let's just keep it all pretty cool. 267 in a day.
That is incredible.
How many hours? Let's say most normal people. I'm not saying that she's a normal person. She's a stalker.
7 hours of sleep, maybe.
Okay, so we'll
Can I remind you as well? They're all handwritten.
That's gonna.
But when it says carpal tunnel, is this like, dear Harry? Like, is it a birthday card?
Dear Harry, still me.
Are they letters?
Like an admiration type bit.
Do you reckon she's
how many words you're gonna read each card?
Enough. Like a birthday card.
What's enough for you?
Like
I would say under 50.
Hi, yeah. Harry, from Sally.
No. Like, hey, Harry, big fan. I saw you at the shops yesterday. I really liked the shirt you were wearing. Can I lick
your
asshole?
That's too much. What we're going to get into is, okay, so we're going to divide this real quickly by, let's say 16 hours. So she's getting 8 hours. Yep. Giving in mind, she has to still eat and drink and shit. And oh, she might
stalk.
Not. She's
going to the both of
us. So we'll go by 16 hours, is that what we said?
Yeah, divide by 16.
So per hour, she's doing 17 cards. Yeah, so then we're going to divide that by 60.
Yep.
So every...
Mate, did we do that right?
Nervous.
I think we did.
Nervous math. Yeah, so every... Yeah.
2.7 minutes she's riding on.
Oh, no, every minute she's doing 0.27 cards.
Yeah, so it's taking 5 minutes to do each card.
Yeah.
Sounds bad. 4 minutes. 4 minutes. 4 minutes to do a card.
Wow.
So maybe she is riding that much.
But that's like... Non-stop
that is her
dedication.
Doing.
Why would you do that? Or unless she bashed him up and was like, "Nah, jeez, I got 7,000 cards to send out, plus the ones I'm gonna write this month."
It's quite an expensive. Cards aren't cheap. The one I got you for your birthday the other week, yeah, like $5, which is like fine. That's fine. You don't have to reimburse.
But 8,000,
I'm doing okay. But yeah, to send
8,000 times five.
How many is that? Hang on.
You think she's doing a little drawing on them?
Should be. That could be nice. $40,000 she's spending. I don't think they're all $5. But that's too expensive.
No, you'd be getting a bulk discount
if you're buying 8,000.
You'd hope so. Yeah, but imagine like writing.
Imagine walking
maybe
into
you post them all in individual envelopes. But or would you just put 100 in one?
But the stalking thing.
Just in a box.
The stalking thing is like one level. But then like to genuinely.
That's snail mail.
Like she wasn't going to get caught if she just continued to stalk him. But her writing these cards is what got her in prison for over a year.
Wait, how long is she in prison?
14 weeks.
Yeah,
I said 14 months.
Because this is also what I was going to say. Prison for 14 weeks.
Kind of chill.
You could just kind of like get jacked. You have a bit of a boot camp. You
yeah,
know?
Get yeah. jacked. And
I think you get other things
get
before
bashed.
You get jacked. I think it, yeah.
Rapid.
But wow. There you go.
There you go.
Bit of a curly
yeah,
one.
It's interesting. Yeah. It's just, so how's it? So you reckon he's getting the cards?
Or
a few things.
They must be landing it somewhere where his team has been like, what's going on here? Who's this random bird? Who's sending him cards?
And she'd already been done on stalking.
I think so.
No.
Oh.
No priors.
Oh, so this is the first venture.
First time.
It's quite an adventurous way to get up and go about things.
Yeah.
Stalus has been targeted by a stalker before. This is a separate thing. It's still interesting.
That doesn't surprise
me. In 2019, a homeless man who spent months camped outside of the pop star's home was found guilty of the offence.
Surely he was just looking for a place to stay. I think we're getting a bit too specific.
Yeah, it's a bit rough.
It's a bit egotistical for Harry.
There's a homeless man who lives near us. We don't think he's stalking us.
Yeah.
Come on, Harry. It's not
Come
all
on,
about
Harry.
It's not all about you, mate. Just let bygones be bygones, brother.
Just accept a card, mate. Some people don't get any.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah.
Grow up.
Come on.
There's a great story with Robert Pattinson, obviously.
We'll be the judge, but yeah.
Of Twilight fame. So he had a stalker. This was after he had done Twilight and stuff.
You'd hope, because before that, who was he?
Yeah.
Just Bobby from the block.
Anyway, he had a stalker, but he like, he was just like chilling kind of. Yeah, he had all his Twilight money. And then, he had a stalker that kept, like, following around. Was that he's, like, come to his house and whatever. And then he was like, oh, you know what? I'm just going to, like, have dinner with him and see if maybe that'll be
Oh, enough. Wow. That is a bold move.
And then he said he just, like, complained to them about his life and stuff. And he said that...
The stalker did.
No. Robert Pattinson did. He said that the stalker got so bored and then he's never seen him since.
There you go.
He was like, man, this is Rob Fazzard guy's not what he's all cracked up to me.
Maybe that's what Harry needs to do. Just bring the doll in.
Yeah, show him the real you.
What would you do with a stalker? Let's say, for example, which one of us is most likely to get stalked? I think Riley. I think, to be honest, Riley, I think you're already... I think there's a few people on my watch.
There's a homeless dude.
Well, how would you cope with it? What would you get? What would you get up to?
Oh, you'd want to be getting cash.
Oh, cash out.
There's a little bit of cash in the car all of a sudden.
Oh, so you'd be going, don't worry about the card, send just donations.
Yeah, right back. Send cash. Then we can meet up. And then once they send the cash, prison them.
Prison, yeah. Boom. Look, they've been sending me all this cash. Get them in prison.
Prism them is not is an interesting adverb.
Yeah, what would you do? Obviously, alert authorities.
Yeah, but you'd play it out a bit. Like, surely.
Oh, I'd be scared that they're going to wear my skin as pajamas.
The old pajama skin.
Yeah. coming to a Woolies near you with your pajama skin.
Yeah, jeez.
Well, what did you do when you were stalking people, though? You're a bit of a...
Just letters. Letters every day. Card Central.
You shat on someone once, didn't you?
No. They just happened to be there.
Alrighty, boys. It's time for one of our favourite weekly segments. In fact, it's our only weekly segment. It's time for our... Everyday Hero Junior Boy, take it away.
Boys, you might notice something a little bit different about me.
We have. The rash is gone.
I got circumcised. No.
Mind you, why does everyone keep asking that whenever we...
So weird.
We keep doing TikTok lives. If you want to join us, that's another just a quick time to opportunity to... If you want to join us on Radio Fremantle, obviously we do the Radio Fremantle. You can tune in the station. But secondly, we like to go live on TikTok. So if you're a fan of the show, you can watch the craft unfold. Speaking of things that are unfolding, people really, that's where we sort of stem from. I want to know if we've got the cut. I think they keep
it's hood or underhood.
Yeah.
That's hoodie our stalkers. Maybe down. We do have stalkers.
Yeah.
Circumcised stalkers or just stalkers.
And they're definitely like people because they're in the chat. Like I'd say something back.
Oh yeah. They want to
say like, are you embarrassed of it? And I'm like,
such a peculiar thing to ask.
And then I said, what are you? I said, drop what you are, and then we'll drop what we are.
Let's move on.
Anywho.
The everyday hero.
So if you notice something different about me, the mullet is gone, boys.
Correct.
Whoa.
It was a courageous act.
It was a bold move. I rocked up
I
rocked up to Frio. And walked in, saw Joe, saw a random hairless man sitting next to him. Well, that looks a little bit like my other brother.
The SA himself.
With no real mention.
Rhyme or reason.
Absolute surprise. In fact, like a week before, 2 weeks before, you were like, yeah, man, I'm thinking about doing it, but just don't think I'm going to, eh? And I was like, well, that was a fun chap.
The old mislead.
And then I rock up next time I seen the bloke. No hair on the old skull.
What happened? Why did it happen?
Oh, it's just getting long and ratty. Did you see the thing?
But that was like 2 years. Yeah,
I started to see it. No, but it was like really unhealthy. And then I started to see a lot of photos from behind and I was like, wow, that sucks.
Wow, dump truck, but that mullet's got to go.
Mullet finna go. Had to clean it up. Had to clean up the act. You know, I'm 21 now.
You are.
The dog days are over.
Oh, Florence, welcome to the pod.
Yeah, but the mullet was gone. It was hashtag Gonskis. And I planned it.
Do your friends who have mullets?
Nah. Not really.
That's the thing.
Oh, so you
too. You were sort of late to the party. Like a lot of them were doing it and then you jumped in and then you just outlived them and outgrew them and then bleached the shit out of them and just really like really got arrogant with it. And then they all cut theirs off because I think they went, oh, big dicks here.
Yeah.
And then you were stuck there with Big Molly.
Big Molly.
Big Mulligan.
Anyway, so I was planning on going to a real official barber because usually I go to Cade's. Cade's a...
Good friend of the show.
He's an underground barber.
I like his cuts because they're subtly amateurish.
Yeah, he keeps them slightly
Speaking of which,
shit.
you need a quick trim, I reckon.
Yeah, I'm going to Kay's on Thursday.
Oh, that's exciting.
Oh, Joey.
Oh, I think I'll probably have to be editing.
Live stream it.
No. Oh, yeah, we could go live.
Take your hood off and then live stream it.
We could go live. We won't.
Anywho.
Do it, yeah.
No, but Cade's a great underground barber. We'll say that. He's good to be an underground barber. But if he walks
in... an underground barber, he's great. But no, he's actually really good, though.
Yeah, no, he does arrive.
And cheap.
Yeah, yeah. Well, that's... You get what you pay for. Anyway. So I was going to... I was asking him a few weeks before. I said, should I go to an official barber and get this drastic change done to my hair? And he said, no, I got you.
No, I got you.
I've hashtag got you, fam. He was like, bro, it's ease. I got you.
To cut hair.
Yeah, he used to cut off a mullet. And I was like, all right. He sent it to Ease. It must be Ease, right? Yeah. So then I went in, booked in a special Friday session with him. He's usually open Thursday nights. Booked in a Friday. He opened the shop up just for me on Friday night.
Wow.
Yeah, I told him in advance. I said, mate, Friday
night. What does he normally do on Fridays?
Rip off.
Yeah, just, just get the tarp out, get the hood down. He's really...
Just flip the hood up and down.
Just crankshaft it, man.
Yeah, but what I said needs to be paid. I went too far.
It's not illegal to crank it.
Oh my god.
That's all he tells me. Anyway.
Continue.
Anyway, so I was there and he was mid crank. And he said, all right, yeah, I'm finna cut your hair. So we got into the barbershop, sat down, and he was like, all right, what are we doing? And I told him, I was like, I want the top to be as long as the back. I want it all to be
and
one.
And he's like, you're going to have to wait a year.
One fluid motion. And he was like, yeah, easy. So he did one rough pass of the mullet to begin. And he showed me in the mirror. He was like, how do you like it? Do you want more cut off? And I said, yeah, let's go more. So he cut off more, then did the sides. And I looked at it again. And I said, cut off more. And then it got to the point where I was like, probably too much.
Yeah. Oh, really?
Yeah, I was like, slightly too much.
Undo.
And then it got to the point where I was kind of like... You're
in tears.
Almost.
You ruined my hair.
No, but I was like, oh, wow. I was like, okay, it's definitely a style. Kind of what I asked for. But not exactly. Anyway. And then he said... Oh, I said, what do you... Because, you know, he's one of my best mates. I was like, what do you think? Like, what do you think of it right now? And he said, and I quote, well, I wouldn't have asked for this. And I said, oh.
Well, I don't remember. I don't remember asking for it either.
Oh, cut it. I'm not going to ask for it.
And I was like, oh, wow. That's good to hear. From the guy holding the bloody scissors.
And the hood.
And his hood. And I was like, wow. And then I got to the point where I was like, okay, just cut it off.
Oh, like shave.
I was like, get rid of the mullet fully. Like, let's just go the sides. Let's go do that all around. And I'll just leave the top to be like long on the top, short back and very short back and sides.
Yeah.
Like, you know, just like that.
Business cut.
Yeah.
Military-esque.
And then he was like, I'm not too sure about that. And I was like, well, what do you mean? He was like, that's a big change.
It is a big change.
You're already halfway there.
And but I was like, yeah, but I can't leave this room looking like this, bro. Like, this is bad. It was worse than what it is now.
And he was like, sorry, this is usually when we close up on Friday.
And he was also kept going on the phone to his mates because they bought these soccer jerseys that they're reselling. And he kept going on his phone, taking calls.
And like, what were you doing?
He was like, yeah, bro, I'll be there hell quick. I just need to finish up Riley's cut, which is also like...
Don't worry, I'll just bloody go. I'll just wing it.
And he was like, I'll be there in like 20, bro. And looked at me, and I was like, this ain't finna be 20 minutes. Anyway, so then.
And you're quite peculiar. Does he know how peculiar you are?
Particular.
Not particular. I just wanted it to be longer.
Didn't speak to Joe for 4 days.
Yeah, but that's because Joe runs.
Joe cut your hair once, and you didn't speak to him for a week. So. Yeah, and me calling you peculiar is a bit out of line.
That was fucked. That actually looked like a scrotum.
Hey, quite impressive. You're the one who asked for it. I wouldn't have asked for it.
Anyway, but we're very, very fortunate enough that the reason Cade cuts hair is because he has a salon on hand because his mum is a hairdresser. She works out of a home studio. Luckily, she was home this lovely Friday night.
She works Fridays.
And he said, he was like, I'll go get my mum. And then I'm going to go shower and get ready and then we'll leave. And I was like, whoa. So I was like, you can't just throw your mum in here and then blame it on her.
This is like the Han Solo movie where the directors were fired when they'd done 80% of the movie and someone else took over.
Yeah, and then I was like, you can't also leave because what if I'm like, you know, in a foul mood?
Yeah, you're not going to yell at his mum. Especially because she's starting with
It's like, okay, the reason I'm here is because I can tell you, it's shit.
Yeah.
You know, I can't say that to your dear mother. Anyway.
But I will.
Anyway, but then she came in and she gave me... It was clear that she was a trained
professional
hairdresser.
Yeah, good.
Because I think that hairdressers not only are fantastic at cutting hair and save for the haircut, but they're very, very good at chatting to the person who's in the chair.
Yeah, they love a chat.
Immediately she walked in and she went, oh, much better.
Oh.
Right? And then she just started like offering compliments saying, why did you want to cut it? Oh my God, it looks so good. Your mum's going to be so happy. Da, da, da. All this stuff.
If you're training to be a hairdresser.
Part of it's chat.
Yeah, yeah.
50% cutting, 50%
chat. It has to be
a
chat unit.
Yeah, I reckon that's a good shout.
Well, yeah, that was the thing, because immediately, like, Kate's in there saying, I wouldn't have asked for this.
Because I don't know how to speak.
And you're the bloke in the chair, like, you're red flags immediately. Like, oh my God, I've just ruined my head.
Yeah.
And then she comes in and she's like, this looks so good. I was thinking, like, I saw you at Kate's 21st.
I thought you looked like a mess.
And I was like, oh, it's getting really long. Like, it's not a good look anymore. Like, he needs to cut it. And she was like, so I was so happy to hear that you were going to cut it.
There you go.
And then immediately I'm just like, oh.
Feel at ease.
Feel relieved. Kate's in the corner eating dinner. Not doing much anymore. And she fixes up the hair and then she goes, what you need to do is this. You need to get this product. You need to do this with the hair.
Cool. A few cashies.
Push it in, push it in this direction. And there you go, Bob's your uncle. And then she threw the mirror up and I was like, that's pretty much what I asked for.
There you go. And Kate's like, oh, well, that's not. Yeah, didn't.
So Kate, stop touching your hood while your mum's in the room. Anyway, and then I was like, yeah, that's pretty much it. Oh my God, thank you so much. And I thought it would be quite fitting because this Sunday is Mother's Day.
Oh, good, I like it.
That Cade's mum receives this week's Everyday Hero.
We love it. So this week's Everyday Hero goes to Cade's mum, who is the haircut helping Everyday Hero. She swoops in when it is required. She might not necessarily be the one you go to.
That's it.
In times of trouble, but she's there in times of need. And that's why she's being awarded episode 190's Everyday Hero. Alrighty, boys, that just about brings us to the end of another episode of the pod. Good week. Good, huge week for the lads.
Jimbo.
We've got Mum joining us next week. I know we flirted with the idea of bringing her on this week, but she'll be definitely on this time next week. Hopefully you all have a lovely Mother's Day. We didn't really actually talk about Mother's Day.
Yeah,
we're going out for dinner.
We're doing a Mother's Day dinner,
which will be
cute.
We
won't tell you stalkers where it is though.
But we are going out. So if you, yeah, hopefully, hopefully
see you there.
Yeah. Actually, didn't 2 months ago we saw?
Yeah,
2 Mother's Days ago we saw Cade and his mum.
We did.
And dropped the Addy because that's probably where they'll be. Yeah, no, we did. Shout out mums.
Oh, well, the chances. So yeah, hopefully everyone enjoys their Mother's Day as well. It's a very important day.
And obviously we're on radio every single Saturday, 8 to 10 a.m.
Yeah, they seem to really be liking our stuff, which, don't worry, it's confusing us just as much as it's confusing you. But yeah, if you are tuning in, we absolutely love it. Keep doing so. And get involved.
On the Instagram.
The only thing you can do more is get involved. We want to hear from you guys.
Yeah, send us a card or 1,000.
No, just a DM will be fine. Boys, until we do this time next week with our darling mother, stay safe, stay blessed, and always remember, don't
go give your mum a hug.
It's ya for now, but not forever.